think only a select few of you guys will know that I am an avid Sonic the Hedgehog fan. Now, and when I say Sonic the Hedgehog fan, I don't just mean somebody casually, but Sonic the Hedgehog is basically my favorite game series, but I've had a lot of gripes with it as of late. And you know, even through the whole decade of horrible games, at least by most people's standards, some of those games were actually pretty entertaining to me. You know, I love Shadow the Hedgehog, but I'm a massive Sonic the Hedgehog follower, and even though I haven't played the most recent games, Sonic Runners, still, I follow the series, and I'm hoping for the day that it'll be able to pick itself up and start to move forward in a positive way, and, you know, have that same level of fun that a lot of the games used to have. And, you know, I'm not one of those Sonic Adventure 3 pushers where, you know, I feel like that's the thing that needs to happen in order for Sonic the Hedgehog to be saved as a franchise, but Sonic's lost his way, and I thought he found his way with Generations, but then things just go downhill from there. I mean, Lost World, you know, it's kind of a mixed bag. There are some positives, some negatives. I didn't even finish the game, and there were a lot of titles after the fact, which kind of could use a little bit. Sonic the Hedgehog, man. Anyways, we have an article today that comes from the SEGA CEO saying that we betrayed Sonic fans and want to be a brand again. Kind of a crazy statement, and as soon as I saw this, I knew I had to talk about it. Like I said, a lot of you new guys, you don't know much about your boy here, man. You don't know much about my past other than my fucking mixtape, but I'm actually a really big Sonic the Hedgehog follower, and you know, I don't like him much now, but I still love the franchise and I want to see it do well, so we are going to be going through this article right now. I know my dude Tails Channel's talked about this, I know my dude Kobe's probably seen this. I'm trying to get in touch with this as well too. Let's see what's going on here, man. Oh, I know Rikki must have seen this too. But Hajime Satomi also teases a new console game announcement at TGS. So, let's see. SEGA CEO Hajime Satomi said that he believes the company betrayed the trust fans put in it over the last few years and added that it is now aiming to improving the quality of its games in hopes of reestablishing itself as a valuable brand. Speaking in an interview with Japanese gaming magazine Famitsu, you guys know Famitsu, really, really popular magazine. A lot of developers do interviews on there. A lot of big high names as well, too, including Sakurai, which has been translated by Silicon Era. Satomi said that he had been discussing strategies to improve the quality of its games with employees. I've been talking to employees about how SEGA should start putting serious consideration into quality from this point on, he said, particularly in North America and Europe, where it's always been more of a focus with schedules. Oh, and just a random thought, I actually didn't play Sonic Boom yet either. I didn't touch that fucking game, because from the moment that Kobe started playing it, I knew. I mean, you don't really have to play the game to understand that it's horrible on all ends. All you gotta do is watch a Let's Play of it, and you'll see every single flaw come out in full damn detail. Sonic Boom, nah. I believe that if we cannot maintain quality, it would be better to not release anything at all. Very, very high standards. So they're holding to themselves, or at least they're saying that they're holding to themselves, or at least they're going to try to uphold from now on. Continuing, Satomi says that he feels the company did its best to build strong connections with the fans of SEGA. They did. You know, SEGA did try to do fan service in their more recent years, but admitted that the games it released may have betrayed that faith. We did our best to build a relationship of mutual trust with older fans of SEGA. But looking back, there have been some titles that have partially betrayed that trust in the past 10 years. You talking about the Decade of Darkness, my dude? SEGA in the 90s was known for its brand, but after that, we lost trust. You're damn right. That's the reason why SEGA is now third party. And we're left with nothing but reputation. We would like to win back the trust and become a brand once again. Way easier said than done. Looking forward, the exec said SEGA is planning to announce something for the home consoles at the Tokyo Game Show. In September 2013, SEGA acquired bankrupt publisher Index Corporation, parent company of Persona 4 developer Atlus. A year later, Index Corporation was separated from Atlus. Shit. The studio was tasked with continuing its game projects, one of which Persona 5, with a team of 121 employees. Index's 166 employees, meanwhile, would focus on distribution, systems development, and advertisements. SEGA seemed to be transitioning away from console games and toward the PC and mobile markets, having invested in three Western developers, the most notable of which is Boston-based firm Demiurge Studios? Well, whatever. Demiurge, which was bought outright by SEGA, worked Harmonix, Gearbox, Irrational, and BioWare. The studio contributed to the multiple Rock Band track packs, built the PC edition of Mass Effect, assisted with art design on the original Bioshock, and worked on the ultimately canceled Wii U version of Aliens Colonial Marines. Its most recent release was the mobile game Marvel Puzzle Quest, which it continues to support. Kind of funny, considering that this article didn't really specifically mention anything Sonic related. Oh man, it was talking more, I guess, of SEGA as a whole rather than Sonic the Hedgehog as a franchise, because I guess they understand themselves. You really can't bring up Sonic the Hedgehog in this kind of a context without starting a huge war in whatever comment section exists for the article. Still, it's good to see that SEGA is trying to redo the way that they approach their games and really bring the quality control back to the forefront. He mentioned the Decade of Darkness, man. And he did mention as well that a lot of their older fans were displeased with SEGA's performance over those 10 years. And I'm glad that they're aware of it, you know. Like I said, SEGA didn't really seem to be a company that, you know, ignored fan requests. They did seem to cater to fan service to an extent. I mean, Sonic Generations is a goddamn direct result of that, but it's been years since Sonic Generations. And to being honest, man, Sonic Boom, like, probably the worst thing that I think SEGA has ever done in the last 10 years. I mean, 2006 was bad, but, you know, we're kind of leaving that era because, you know, it's 2016. So, I mean, yeah, definitely Sonic Boom, man. The first, like, oh my god, man. Well, they didn't really mention Sonic the Hedgehog specifically here, so there's nothing for us to really say that's going to happen that'll probably change things up. I mean, we got Sonic Boom 2 coming out for 3DS. The 3DS games were slightly better than the console version, so all we can hope and pray and say is that Sonic Boom 2 Fire and Ice is going to be a more acceptable game. Although I really don't have much confidence in saying that, but all we can do is hope, I suppose. He said, SEGA is planning to announce something for the home consoles at the Tokyo Game Show. I didn't know nothing about Tokyo Game Show, so let's see exactly when that happens. Tokyo Game Show 2015. When does this take place? Okay, so it is happening on September 19th. 2015. Okay, so all right, the 19th and the 20th, so in September. That's not too much time until we find out what SEGA is trying to bring to the home consoles. No idea if it's a Sonic game or not, but either way, it'll be something interesting to see, keep in mind, considering that SEGA is trying to take a more quality approach to things. But like I said, talk is cheap. Let's see what you got, SEGA. I'm hoping and praying that you do have Sonic in consideration when making these new, you know, these new resolutions on your franchises. I hope so. Anyways, guys, let me know what you think about this in the comments, and I'll talk to you in the next video. Take care of yourselves, and of course, as usual, please have yourself a damn good one.